I mean, it feels like we've been talking about this matchup for a long time. I'm sure it feels like that times 100 for you.
Yeah.
Are you sick of talking about Danny Sabatello, or is this has this gotten to be fun leading into this?
I've been having fun the whole time, you know. I just feel like this is gonna be the funnest part, you know. I feel like most competitive part. This is gonna be the most competitive part. I feel like the fight is not gonna be very competitive. So bring on all the trash talk, cause that's the more chips on the table, and I get to throw in your face, you know, when I beat the shit out of you.
You've had what, like, nearly 6 months to know that it was him, right?
Yeah.
Obviously, you're not gonna do a 6 month actual training camp.
Right.
He's probably been in your mind one way or another.
Yeah.
Every day since he won his last fight. So.
Yeah.
Have you been in a situation like that before, and have you gotten comfortable with it?
The closest I've been to that is like being ranked, you know, while I was in wrestling, you know, and knowing like I'm gonna face somebody at the end of the year that I have to face. I'm pretty cool with it, you know. I just go about it like any other camp. Like, yeah, I gotta fight him at the end of the year, but this camp is still gonna be like an 8 to 9 week camp, and you know, I'll prepare just like always, you know. I'll do all the extra things that I've always done. I'm 18-1 for a reason. I've stood up to almost every challenge that's been presented to me, you know, and passed it with flying colors. So I don't think this will be any different.
One of the things that he's liked to say, I mean, he said it to us today. He said it in Chicago with you a couple weeks ago. He said it prior to that, is that he thinks he's in your head.
Yeah.
If he's not, does that work to your advantage to let him keep thinking that he's up there?
Yeah, I think it does. I think it works to my advantage because he must not understand my head and like how I think, you know? I feel like I can turn on my viciousness, you know, turn it off and on, and I am like ready and willing, you know, to put myself in a position to be very vicious this fight. As far as like my day-to-day, I got a lot of stuff going on, man. I got 2 kids at home, you know? I got a wife, I got like family and stuff, you know? So I don't feel like he's in my head as much as he thinks it is, but if he thinks I am, maybe I'm in his head, and yo, he don't got a lot to think about. He say he go to sleep and think about me, so I'm sure I'm definitely in his head.
I asked him this too, but can you give us like your Cliff Notes version of how this beef kind of started with him anyways? I mean,
yeah.
If it was up to you, would there be no beef with him?
No, that'd definitely be okay. Beef. Before we even fought, you know, he was somebody, I just see the way he treats his people or the way he talks about people. And I kind of see him like talking about people that don't have they don't have wrestling. They don't have the means to like defend themselves, you know? And he's talking crass. He talked crass about Sergio, talked crass about a lot of people in the Bellator organization all across the world. And I don't vibe with that, you know what I mean? So I've always also been like the type of person that's, if somebody's like the toughest guy in the room and they're like boasting about it, like I kind of just want to beat that guy up, you know? So I just don't like, you know, the way he carries himself in that respect. You know, the way he, you know, disrespects people, I just don't like.
Do you consider him like a bully? I mean, is that...
I consider him a bully to some people, you know?
But you don't think that he's trying to bully you necessarily, or is he trying to bully
you? Yeah, no, I think he thinks he can bully, you know, I think he thinks he can bully me, but that's, like, part of the allure of, like, fighting him, like, oh, you don't know, I got a freaking pocket knife, or I got something, you know, for you, you know what I mean? You're not, like, ready for it, so... I'm looking forward to it.
Appreciate it, man. Thank you.
Ralph, out of the 3 other guys left, who's the toughest puzzle to figure out?
I figure Magomedov, opposed to that, I figured out, but I feel like we'll be a tougher opponent the second time. I think he's the toughest puzzle to figure out.
And do you actually even care what type of a fight this winds up being, if it's a stand-up or if you...
This fight between Sabatello?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I don't care. I feel like I'm literally better than him everywhere. The only place he poses a threat is wrestling. And that's an edge. He probably maybe edges me in wrestling. Anywhere else, I feel like I dominate him. If we were to do a jiu-jitsu match, if we were to do a striking match, if we were to do a wrestling match, he might win by a riding point or something. He might win like very, very seldom. to be honest, I feel like I beat the shit out of him, but just, I like to give my opponent the benefit of the doubt. Like, if I give him the benefit of the doubt, then I'll give him a point, maybe. But yeah, so I feel like I'm better than him everywhere.
I don't know if you're gonna really want to answer this one, but...
Yeah, I don't care.
In training camp, who's pushed you more to become a better fighter? Rufus or Eric Nixon?
I would definitely say Rufus Sport pushed me more because they were like responsible for a lot of my growth. When I came to Eric Nixon, he was like tightening up a lot of things, you know? He wasn't tightening up the things. He was adding to the base I already had. And I developed my base from Rufus Sport. I was a Rufus Sport fighter for 7 years, you know? I went to Eric Nixon's for a camp, you know? And he was able to mold or work with what he had. Rufus Sport did the blunt of the work, and I always accredit Rufus Sport for my development and my foundation.
Thanks.
No problem.
Yeah.
You said you're having a lot of fun with this.
Yeah.
Your last post on IG was some type of character saying a human highlighter, some type of ostrich. Is that a way of getting in his head, irking him, or?
Yeah, for me, it's like, it's funny. When I see funny, I say he looked like the character Sid off of Ice Age, you know? And it was funny because he did look like the character. I think that too, that type of stuff like piss him off because you don't understand what's going on in my head. I think this shit is hilarious, you know? Like, oh, you gonna bash my head in? Okay, you gonna bash my head. When you ever bash my head in? I think it's hilarious, you know? So I'm just making fun of him in that fact. Like, he wants to be serious, but again, it's a facade from the way he actually fights and the way he actually like approaches fighting, you know what I mean? And that's why I feel like he feels he is a smart fighter because everything he does is an illusion, you know what I mean? So, yeah, I think it's funny.
Raufeon, obviously you guys both said that this has kind of gotten personal. Have you ever had a fight get this personal before?
Not to this extent. I fought Rob Emerson once and he said I was a young dumb kid that wasn't ready for this or something. So we had a bunch of like words back and forth, but nothing to this extent. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm surprised that you kind of complimented his wrestling when you're actually the more decorated wrestler.
Yeah.
And Patchy and Magomed both said that like his skill's not that good. He gets all the excitement because he's talking, that his skills are overrated. Do you agree with them?
I agree with that. But okay, so I agree and don't get me wrong. I think I beat the shit out of him wrestling. But in my head, for training purposes and for fighting purposes, I have to imagine the best version of him, right? So the best version of him could be best. It's probably, in reality, the best version of him is not better than the worst version of me. But for training purposes, I can't, you know, go into training and be thinking like, oh, this guy freaking sucks, you know, I'm never, you know what I mean? I gotta be thinking progression and how I can progress. I gotta have somebody across from me that will pose a threat. That's why I don't believe the fight will be very, very, very competitive, but I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt for his wrestling, the one thing he can do.
You know, I know you don't want to look too far ahead to the next matchup, but obviously you keep getting asked about that. How hard is it to keep yourself to not look ahead to, you know, two other killers on the other side?
Man, this one has kind of been easy because I'm looking so much, looking forward to putting holes in this dude's face. So this is like pretty easy, you know what I mean? To like not think about Magomed or Patchy Mix. So yeah, the talking, to be honest with you, I think the talking is going to hurt Danny more than it's going to help him. Like literally, it's going to hurt him. So I think the talking is helping with that.
When the tournament first started, obviously all the guys were added to, did you kind of expect it to be sitting where it is right now, the four guys, or did one fight really surprise you?
No, I didn't. I was hoping Sabatello made it to this point, but I didn't believe he would. I also didn't think Patchy Mix would be Horiguchi though. So I thought it would be Magomed Horiguchi, and it would be me versus one of the, well, in the beginning of the tournament I was supposed to fight Sergio, and then Juan Archuleta was, I think, in one of those spots or something. After the tournament changed, I thought it was gonna be Horiguchi, Magomed, and then me, and I was hoping for Sabatello, but It was Higo.
No, I know.
Or I thought it was Higo.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. I know you and Sergio's obviously, you're the interim champion. He's the official champion. Yep. You guys trained together for a really long time. I know you've kind of been training elsewhere now. Mm-hmm. Did you leave because of that future matchup?
No, so I left because I had a second child, my little fat baby, Ikechukwu. yeah, I had a second child and I'm from Houston. So I was just... the plan was to just go to Houston to like live, and then when I had camps, I was gonna go back to Rufus Sport. But then, so I had a fight where I trained at Rufus Sport for Magomedov, and then the next fight was Sergio. So the next fight, I had to change camps pretty much.
I know one of the unwritten rules of MMA in the fighters are you don't talk about training.
Yeah.
But when you leave camp, it seemed like, and we've seen many teammates that face each other, they do start talking about training.
Yeah.
So who got the better in the training? You were
In the better of the training, I would say I beat this. No. No. To be honest with you, I learned a lot from Sergio, like a lot, you know. And majority of that was on my feet, you know. And so he got the better of me in the exchanges on my feet, and then he learned a lot from me wrestling wise, you know. So a majority of wrestling, and I would beat him in like the wrestling exchanges. Toward the end, it was like what and what. Like he would get some takedowns, he would control some positions. I would light him up on the feet sometimes. Literally, it was back and forth. It was good rounds, you know. And that's why I feel like he was like one of my best training partners. I think I posted maybe when he was about to fight for the belt. We were still both like ranked high. I posted like two of the best in the world, you know. I think two of the best of the Bellator, the best in the world. Like I truly believe that because our rounds were spectacular. They were like really back and forth. And yeah, he really pushed me, so.
Do you want to go into politics after that? Because that was a very good political answer.
Oh yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? Maybe sometime, you know what I mean? I can do the Herschel Walker.
reporting in live with Raufeon Stots, rank Danny Sabatello's trash talking ability from 1 to 10.
Okay, I understand that his talking ability is different from my talking ability. I'm coming at him by stuff by his chin, his Buzz Lightyear chin, his hair lighter head, you know what I'm saying, him looking like Sid. You know, he's coming at me with, fuck you, Raufeon's a bitch. Raufeon's a bitch, you know what I mean? So, I feel like my trash talking is more diverse, and it's more, maybe fan friendly. I feel like his trash talking is shit, but, I'll rate it a... I'll give him a 6 for conviction.
He said -2 when I asked.
Ah, he got me, -2. I'll give him a 6 for conviction. The way he commits to doing it, I'll give him a 6, but it sucks.
All right, thanks, Raufeon.